What's up, everybody? This is your boy, the Executioner, Mark Knight, and I'm here to give you tonight's Monday Night Raw recap. Monday Night Raw was live tonight from Washington, D.C. at the Verizon Center. The host of the show tonight was the Three Stooges, which they were there to hype up and promote their movie, which is coming out this Friday. The commentators tonight was Michael Cole and Jerry the King Lawler. Segment number one, John Laurinaitis with David Otunga comes out ringside talking about the new era of people power. And the reintroduction of Brock Lesnar. They show highlights of him attacking John Cena last week. And sets up their singles match that's going to take place at Extreme Rules. Michael Cole runs down all of Brock Lesnar's accomplishments as Brock Lesnar's coming ringside. He is a former UFC champion. Mentions that he is a three-time WWE champion. But does not acknowledge the fact that Brock Lesnar is also a former IWGP champion. That's just on a side note. For all you smart wrestling fans out there, that's what he was. He held the IWGP belt for about 7 months. Brock Lesnar comes out saying that Laurinaitis is the man by being smart, by bringing me back to the company and putting me on top, and calls John Cena a loser pretty much. Cena comes out wearing his green shirt, mixed reaction as always. He gets in the ring and he smacks the living dog out of Brock Lesnar like he owes him money, which is hilarious in my book. Both guys get into a brawl with the double leg trip, and he punches John Cena right all up in the face, all up in the grill area. So John Cena's busted in the mouth wide open, and then you get your pull away. You get your pull away from all of the guys, from the locker room, the agents coming out to break up this fight. So it was a real good way to start off Monday Night Raw tonight, a pure six brawl, straight up old-fashioned pro wrestling at its finest. It reminds me of the good old days of pro wrestling. No need for talk, loads of heat, and just straight up ass kicking. And it was a good way to start it off. However, I think John Laurinaitis is just a big goof, and everyone knows that. I think he forgets the rule about drawing first blood. And then he berates Teddy Long for not handling John Cena, which was the first backstage segment. Then we have the tag match, the opening contest. Santino Marella and Brodus Clay versus Dolph Ziggler and Jack Swagger. Very good match. Brodus Clay and Santino getting the win over Jack Swagger and Dolph Ziggler. Interesting side note, Vicky Guerrero comes out and says that her team is the tag team of the universe. Side note, last I checked, the tag team champions of the universe are my dudes, the DRS, the Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. Shout out to my dudes right there. Like I said, it was Brodus and Santino getting the win over Ziggler and Jack Swagger. Then we have a promo with Miz and Johnny, and then we have Eve and Johnny going back and forth talking about, come see me in Toronto and Stanford, I'll take care of some stuff with you. Then he calls in Teddy Long and he says, you know what, Teddy, you're an idiot. I told you to keep John Cena in control, but you didn't do that. Where is he? I want you to get him in here. You took too long. John Cena comes in and says, listen, you know what? I live for this. I breathe for this. And I'm glad that this happened. You see this right here? This isn't going to stop me from doing what I need to do tonight. So you give me an opponent so I can beat the dog snot out of them. And then he sets up for John Cena versus David Otunga. And he tells Teddy Long to go out there and you tell David Otunga that I'm going to be ringside with him. They highlight the co-main event for tonight, which is CM Punk versus Mark Henry for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship title. Then we have another backstage segment with Santino searching around for the Three Stooges, and he runs into Kane, and he turns around and dip off. Side note, the WWE World Heavyweight Championship is the World Heavyweight Championship, which is held by CM Punk. Now, you might be wondering, what do I mean by that? Well, if you know the geology of the WWE World Heavyweight title, you'll see that it is still the World Heavyweight Championship. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. The SmackDown version of the World Heavyweight title, nothing but a prop, and everyone knows that. So then the next match, we have R-Truth versus Cody Rhodes. Very interesting matchup. Both former champions, U.S. and Intercontinental champion. Truth over Cody Rhodes with the distraction by the Big Show getting the pinfall over the ex-Intercontinental champion. Santino continues to then search around the arena looking for the Stooges, only to find a big, huge box. He pries the box open, and the Stooges come out. Now, I'm going to tell you something right now. Anyone that's been living under a rock knows the Three Stooges, the original Three Stooges, and this is going to be a rehash of their origin story for this era coming out this Friday. The only thing that I'm kind of hoping to see, and I was glad to see this, that Will Sasso would do something very funny tonight and give us a great wrestling impersonation. But we'll get into that later. Then we go into Giant Bernard taking on Yoshitatsu. Now, yes, I call him Giant Bernard because that's who he is, Matt Bloom. Burn all this Lord Tensai crap. You know, he is Giant Bernard. He's a former Noah. He is a former New Japan. He is a former WWE Tag Team and Intercontinental Champion, Hardcore Champion, and European Champion. He destroys Yoshitatsu. Now, it's interesting because earlier today there were some guys all over the internet talking about Yoshi needs to be pushed on television. Well, he got pushed tonight. Pushed around. Anyway, Giant Bernard with the win over Yoshitatsu by referee decision. CM Punk versus Mark Henry begins, but it starts off with a promo between CM Punk talking about Jericho crossing the line, not minding his business, and not having to bring my business out in the forefront. Jericho comes up on the mic and says, you know what, you're drunk, you're going to be a drunk like your dad, and that's just the bottom line, so there's nothing you can do about it. You're going to realize you're going to end up embracing the fact that you're going to take a drink and call it a day. Hindsight, the match goes in, and it takes place, but the match is rather short due to the fact that CM Punk gets himself disqualified by intentionally beating up on Mark Henry with the television monitor. Jericho comes out with two cases of beer. Mark Henry gets the distraction on CM Punk, hits him with two World's Strongest Slams, sets up for Jericho to pour the beer on the guy. CM Punk gets up to put up a gallant effort to fight, but he gets one code breaker to the face. Then he gets beer poured on him. Then he starts to climb back up. As he's starting to climb back up, he goes to go for a single leg takedown. Jericho counters with another code breaker, and bam, he starts to pour more beer on Chris Jericho. I wonder where this is going to go, Jericho, because you're a great wrestler. You draw great heat, but damn, bro, stop wasting the booze. There are a lot of people that like Jack Daniels, and by the way, you know, we all know it was a sugar bottle last week, but don't go wasting beer. But then again, it probably was Canadian beer. So that's all that was. Next, we had Alberto Del Rio versus Zack Ryder. Another interesting matchup. This was pretty decent between both guys. Alberto Del Rio getting a warm-up as he's preparing for his matchup against Sheamus for the World Heavyweight title. They were talking about Sheamus and the actions that he did last week by attacking, actually getting caught with the chair and attacking the referees with several brawl kicks because Del Rio worked his way into getting the title match. Either way, Del Rio getting the win over Zack Ryder. Also, then we have the final Stooge promo with Will Sasso coming out doing an impression of Hulk Hogan in the red and the yellow. He's doing it, promoting the movie, plugging the movie, and then in comes Kane, and he hits Will Sasso with a choke slam, and it was a wonderful, wonderful looking choke slam, and it was a good segment. Then we go into the next segment with Mark Henry with a promo with Josh Matthews talking about how Punk will not escape him next week because he's going to challenge him for the title and it is going to be a no DQ match. Then we have another promo with Brock Lesnar and Josh Matthews. Matthews is interviewing Brock. Brock goes on to saying that he's glad that he's back in the WWE. He's proud of everything he's done, but John Cena is not the top man. John Cena will never be the top man. As a matter of fact, John Cena can't even hold my jockstrap. Where I come from, those are fighting words. So he says, I'll see him at Extreme Rules. And that's just how it goes from there. Then we go into the recap of the end of the era match between The Undertaker and Triple H. Great, great, great wrestling for all the wrestling fans that saw it. It was the show stealer. It was the match of the night. It was the number one contest at WrestleMania, hands down. It just blew the entire show away. And it had all of the wrestlers just giving their high side about the matchup. And these interviews and promos is going to be on the new WWE DVD release that's coming out in the summer, which is called The Streak 20-0, The Undertaker. And then we go into the main event, John Cena versus David Otunga. Pretty decent match. Of course, for all the Cena haters out there, of course, you know, I know you guys hate John Cena because you think he's lame, he can't work, he can't do this, he can't do that. But you know what? You guys are just a bunch of haters, and you guys don't understand the wrestling business. John Cena, granted, might not be the best wrestler in your eyes and in your opinion, but the guy is a trained professional wrestler, and the guy knows how to work. Hell, if he didn't know how to work, he wouldn't have been a 10-time world champion. He wouldn't be able to crawl up under your skin. He wouldn't be able to piss you off, and he wouldn't be able to get you to chant, "Cena sucks." Either way, great chain wrestler from John Cena on this behalf. It was a very good match. Of course, David Otunga getting a lot of heat as well, gaining control for the upper hand of the match, but then Cena comes back and gets the win, hitting Otunga with the STFU, making him submit. And as he's getting ready to celebrate, out comes Brock Lesnar with a low blow to the groin section, and then another F5 to lay out John Cena. Overall, I'm going to give this show a 3.5. I mean, it's Monday Night Raw, and usually you'll get a 3.5 on a Monday Night Raw. I don't normally give ratings, but I figure, hey, why not? I might as well just give a rating to this one. So it was a pretty good match tonight. So either way, folks, I'm about to be up on out of here. Tomorrow night, we got that live SmackDown. I don't know where they're shooting it from or whatever, but it's a live SmackDown, and it's the old school blast from the past. You're going to have all of the legends. I think I have my notes from last Friday's show over here. I believe that's right. The hyping of the old school SmackDown. They got the following wrestlers that's going to be there: Gene Okerlund, Roddy Piper, Dusty Rhodes, Ted DiBiase, Jimmy Hart, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Pat Patterson, Sergeant Slaughter. All of these guys are going to be there next week to hype up the old school Blast from the Past SmackDown for tomorrow night. So it's going to be a pretty good show. So, folks, until then, I'm out of here. But you know what to do. Like me on Twitter. No, actually, follow me on Twitter, XM Nightbuster. Like me on Facebook, Mark A. Morrell. Leave your comments and all of your questions that you have about tonight's show or any other questions that you may have. Leave that on the YouTube page. I'll respond back to it as soon as I can. And if you have any questions, you have anything that you want to bring to the table to this format of the show, feel free to do so. You know, my channels are always open, so please be sure to do that. And until then, folks, I'll see you guys, I guess, tomorrow night with the SmackDown review. So until then, folks, I'm Mark Knight. I'm the Executioner. I will see you guys on the flip side. It's good for me and it's bad for you. And remember, you know, like they always say in YouTube land, follow this, like me on this, yada, 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 yakety, smackety. I'll see you guys on the flip. Peace.